Hello students, welcome to the answer writing class. And in this class I will be dealing with the answers to the questions that I had uploaded on 4th of December on brainiki.com. So the first question was, analyze rapid survey on children report. Now as far as this report is concerned, this report is published by UNICEF. So this report has highlighted about the certain indicators about the health of children. The first indicator that it had highlighted is about the stunting. And then another indicator that it has highlighted in its report is about the underweighing of the children, underweight. So it had thrown light on these two indices. And it has further delved deep about these indices by analyzing about the differentiation between these two indices, that is the stunting and the underweighing of the children in the urban areas, and the stunting and the underweighing of the children in the rural areas. Now what this report has highlighted is that the stunting and the underweighing is more in the rural areas in comparison to the urban areas. Overall, there has been a decline in the stunting and in the underweighing of the children in India. Now, what this actually highlights? This highlights that India has improved in providing good health services to the children, in enhancing their health status. Now, what this report doesn't highlight is about the latent health, the latent hunger, about the micronutrient deficiency. What this report doesn't highlight is about the mortality rate, infant mortality rate. Now what we are targeting is 1 per 1,000 infant mortality rate. Another things highlighted by this report are like the states of Manipur, Mizoram and Kerala, they have performed phenomenally well. But there are states like Uttar Pradesh, like Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand, which have performed very badly on the indices of stunting and underweighing. So the time for India is to gear up to strengthen its entire medical edifice so that we can provide a good human resource to the country in the future. So this should have been the conclusion of this answer, and this should have been the body part. Now the second question is about polio free tag for India is a farce. Now polio free tag. Now India has already been declared to be a polio free country. But there are instances in India in which we still see the muscle atrophy in the children, in which we see the symptoms in the children are almost same like that of polio. So why such symptoms are seen in the children? Now the symptoms that we are witnessing among the children, they are not because of the wild polio virus. So we have waged a war on wild polio virus. We have won the war against wild polio virus. But there is something else against which we have not been able to win a war. This is vaccine derived polio virus. Now when this vaccine is given to the children, it is actually a virus. A small amount of virus is given to the children, this viral dose is given to the children so that we can activate their immune system to fight against a large intrusion of the wild polio virus. Now what happens in unsanitized areas, that this virus, it gets multiplied and it goes out through the feces and it pollutes the area and the children who are living in unhygienated areas, it pollutes those children. So unko bahut zyada unhygienic conditions mein jab rehte hain log, to ye wala virus multiply kar jata hai. Multiply karne se hamare paas jo acute फिलारिसिस केसेस आते हैं पोलियो वायरस को लेके, वो अब भी इंडिया में 50,000 के करीब हमारे पास केस आता है, बट वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन केसेस को नहीं देखता है. तो इसीलिए जो ये जो टैग दिया गया है इंडिया को पोलियो फ्री वायरस वाला, ये दिस इज एक्चुअली अ फार्स बिकॉज अभी हमने इसको फाइट अच्छी तरह से नहीं किया है. तो वैक्सीन के दोबारा भी हमारे पास पोलियो के केसेस आ रहे हैं एंड देर आर अदर इडियोपैथिक केसेस ऑफ पोलियो वायरसेस. तो व्हाट इज इडियोपैथी? इडियोपैथी इसका कारण नहीं पता है कि इस तरह का वायर पोलियो क्यों हो जाता है. न्यू पोल दैट इज नॉन पोलियो केसेस जो फिलारसिस के आते हैं हमारे पास, जहां पे मसल एट्रोफी लोग बच्चों को हो जाता है. सो द थर्ड क्वेश्चन वॉज क्रिटिकली एनालाइज चाइल्ड लेबर लॉज इन इंडिया, हाउ फार they are effective, they have been effective should have been the question. So it's some sort of grammatical mistake. So till now we have been not allowing the children below the age of 14 to participate in the hazardous jobs, but the government and this law which defines this thing, it was made an act in 1986, Child Labor Prohibition and Rehabilitation Act. But now the government is coming out with a new act. So, कोई भी act आता है किसी भी चीज को लेके उसमें दो तीन provisions होती है. पहले तो आपने define किया गया होता है कि child labor क्या है. Secondly, आप उसमें define करते हो कि उसमें penalty कितना देना है, सजा कितनी देनी है अगर कोई child labor कराएगा. और तीसरा, आप उस मिनास को खत्म करने के लिए क्या करते हो, कुछ रिहैबिलिटेटिव एंड डेवलपमेंटल मेजर्स इंक्लूड करते हो. अभी 2014 वाला जो बिल अभी पेंडिंग है जिसको के बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट लेके आ रही है, दे हैव रीडिफाइंड दीज थिंग्स. नाउ व्हाई दे हैव रीडिफाइंड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ चाइल्ड लेबर, दे हैव रीडिफाइंड द डेफिनेशन बिकॉज अंडर राइट टू एजुकेशन एक्ट 14 साल के बच्चे को पढ़ाई करनी जरूरी है हिंदुस्तान में. तो 14 साल से कम बच्चे को हम जस्टिफाई नहीं कर सकते कि वो चाइल्ड लेबर में भी जाए. पहले हम उसको कह रहे थे कि 14 साल के कम वाला बच्चा नॉन हजार्डस जॉब में काम कर सकता है, बट इसको हमने चेंज कर दिया है. अभी 14 साल से कम वाला बच्चा काम कर सकता है, सिर्फ कौन सा काम, जो उसका फैमिली का प्रोफेशन है. कौन सा काम, एंटरटेनमेंट का काम. कौन सा नहीं कर सकता, हजार्डस काम नहीं कर सकता, सर्कस में काम नहीं कर सकता, नॉन फैमिली प्रोफेशंस में काम नहीं कर सकता. बट दिस थिंग विल बी मैनिपुलेटेड बाय द पीपल हु आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन बिजनेसेस विच एम्प्लॉय दिस चिल्ड्रन फॉर गेटिंग द लेबर डन. नाउ इट अभी जो एक्ट बनने जा रहा है इसमें इस चीज को लेके प्रिकॉशन नहीं है. एंड फर्स्ट टाइम अगर किसी को पता लगेगा कि किसी के मां बाप ने अपने बच्चे को एम्प्लॉय किया, पहली बार उसको सजा नहीं दी जाएगी. तो पीनल प्रोविजन बहुत ही ज्यादा डाइल्यूटेड है, बहुत ही ज्यादा मॉडरेट है. सो अभी हमें पीनल प्रोविजन को मॉडरेट से स्ट्रिंजेंट करना है, स्ट्रिक्ट बनाना है. एंड वी शुड ऑल्सो ट्राई टू फिल द loopholes which might allow the people to still employ the children which it intends to inhibit, which it intends to stop. To wo abhi bhi nahi ho payega. So the fourth question is, what is integrated power development scheme? Now as far as the power sector is concerned in India, we have been doing n number of reforms. We had Electricity Act in 2003 that allowed for the de-licensing in the distribution, that allowed the de-licensing in the generation of the electricity from the entire resources except the hydel one. The big hydel project still has to take a license. But all others were de-licensed. The metering was introduced, under cabling was introduced. But still what we see in India, we are having lot of transmission and distribution losses. Then we are having technical and commercial losses. The total losses to the electricity sector is about 24 to 27% of the entire electricity that is generated in India is getting lost. But if you look at the global standards, just 7 to 8%. बहुत ज्यादा बिजली हमारी चोरी हो जाती है. इस चीज को दूर कर ठीक करने के लिए 12th 5-year plan में रिस्ट्रक्चर्ड एक्सेलरेटेड पावर डेवलपमेंट एंड रिफॉर्म प्रोग्राम लेके आई थी सरकार, उसको दोबारा से चेंज कर दिया एक्सेलरेटेड रिस्ट्रक्चर्ड पावर डेवलपमेंट एंड रिफॉर्म प्रोग्राम. अभी इन सबको क्लब कर दिया गया है एंड दे इंट्रोड्यूस दिस इंटीग्रेटेड आईपीडीएस प्रोग्राम, इंटीग्रेटेड पावर डेवलपमेंट स्कीम. नाउ दिस स्कीम विल नॉट ओनली फोकस ऑन ट्रांसमिशन एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन लॉसेस, कमर्शियल एंड टेक्निकल लॉसेस, बट इट विल ऑल्सो फोकस ऑन मेकिंग दिस एंटायर ग्रिड सिस्टम आईटी कंपैटिबल, इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी कंपैटिबल. And we will also be introducing the renewable aspect in this integrated power development scheme. And along with that, the focus will also remain on filling the gaps in the pilferage of the electricity in India. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.